डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल ए टू बी एफ ऑफ एक्स डीएक्स। सपोज दिस इज अ डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल हुज लोअर लिमिट, दिस इज कॉल्ड लोअर लिमिट, बी इज कॉल्ड अपर लिमिट। नाउ इफ एफ ऑफ एक्स इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ अ फंक्शन फाई ऑफ एक्स, सपोज इफ एफ ऑफ एक्स इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ अ फंक्शन फाई ऑफ एक्स, देन दिस कैन बी रिटन एज ए टू बी फाई डैश एक्स डी एक्स। फाई डैश इंडिकेट्स डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ फाई ऑफ एक्स एंड देन इंटीग्रेशन, सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू फाई ऑफ एक्स लिमिट ए टू बी विच इज इक्वल टू फाई ऑफ बी अपर लिमिट माइनस फाई ऑफ ए। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंटीग्रल ऑफ जीरो टू पाई बाय टू कॉस एक्स डी एक्स, तो कॉस एक्स इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ साइन एक्स, देयरफॉर इट्स इंटीग्रल इज साइन एक्स एंड लिमिट इज फ्रॉम जीरो टू पाई बाय टू। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शैल पुट एक्स इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय टू हियर अपर लिमिट इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्स वेर एवर एक्स इज देयर, देन माइनस लोअर लिमिट। साइन ऑफ पाई बाय टू इज वन माइनस साइन ऑफ जीरो इज जीरो, सो फाइनली द आंसर इज वन। नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल वन टू टू एक्स स्क्वायर डी एक्स, इंटीग्रल ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर एज यू नो एक्स क्यूब अपॉन थ्री 1 to 2. So first we shall put x is equal to 2. So it becomes 2 to the power 3 upon 3 minus 1 to the power 3 upon 3. 8 by 3 minus 1 by 3. 7 by 3. So finally the answer is 7 by 3. Similarly, if you integrate 1 to 2 t square dt, again its integration with respect to t will be t cube by 3 1 to 2, and you can experience it that the answer will be same as it is in question number 2. So what is the important thing here? The important thing that definite integrals are independent of variable. You can experience here. Definite integrals are independent of variable. Means whether it is x or t, if limits are same, functions are same, answers will be same. We will prove it later on. Just now we see a question in which we shall change the limit. So question is 0 to 2 x sec square x square dx. So to integrate this, what usually we do, we use to substitute t is equal to x square and then we differentiate it. So we shall differentiate it dt by dx, that will be 2x. We have x dx here, x dx. So this we can write dt by 2 x dx. Means x dx we can replace by dt by 2. Now what about the limits? So limits will be changed now, because limits, existing limits are values of x, means x is varying from 0 to 2. But as and when we substitute x square is equal to t, means now we are introducing some other variable. So limits will not be of t now, limits will be changed and it will be of t now. So when x is 0, how to change limits? Limits should be changed with the help of this only, t is equal to x square. Whatsoever we have substituted, the substitution will change the limit. So when x is 0, t will be what? So t will be 0 square is 0. So, and when x is 2, t will be 2 square, means 4. So earlier limits were from 0 to 2. Now it is from 0 to 4. So the integral, let's say that this integral is I. Therefore, the integral I is equal to 0 to 2. Instead of 0 to 2, we shall write 0 to 4. Sec square x square. X square is t. X dx we can replace by dt by 2. 1 by 2 being a constant can be taken common. Integral of sec square t is 10t. 0 to 4. Now the most important thing, we need not to put value of t here, because we have changed the limit. So the answer will be, first of all, we shall put upper limit instead of t, 10 4 minus 10 of 0. 10 of 0 is 0. So the final answer is 1 by 2 tan 2, tan 4. What the important changes are here? First, that whenever we substitute, we need to change the limits. Second, at the end of the answer, we need not to put value of the substituted value. And at the last, the most important thing, an integral constant plus c must not be added. If anybody adds an integral constant in definite integral, then their marks will be deducted. So be careful. Nobody is allowed to use integral constant in definite integral, because definite integrals are having their limits from this value to that value. Therefore, it cannot have something as a constant or something as an additional value. Its value will be certain. Let's see another example, example number 2. Again, we are taking a question in which we shall change the limit. So integral 2 to 5 log x whole square upon x. Let the integral be is equal to I. As you are aware what to do, we shall put t is equal to log x as usual. whenever we put, we use to differentiate. So on differentiating, dt by dx 1 by x, dt is equal to dx upon x. Clearly, dx upon x can be replaced by dt. Log x will be replaced by t. Now, we will have to change the limits. Most important thing. When x is equal to 2, t will be log 2. Do we need to have values of log 2 and log 5? No. We can leave the answer in terms of log until we are given their values. When x is 5, t is equal to log 5. So existing limit is 2 to 5. Now it will be from log 2 to log 5. T square log x whole square is t square. Dx upon x can be replaced by dt. Integral of t square will be t cube by 3. Limits will be from log 2 to log 5. Log 5 whole cube upon 3 minus log 2 whole cube upon 3. So finally, this is the answer of the given question. Let's discuss an integral in which we apply product rule known as integration by parts. For example, integral 1 to 2 x e to the power x dx. Now to integrate this, we shall apply product rule of this called integration by parts. Assume and rule, I think, is clear to you. First constant, integral of second, differential of first, integral of second, and then integration of whole. So x constant, integration of e to the power x minus differentiation of x, integration of e to the power x dx. What about the limits? So in such cases, you need to write like this. X is from 1 to 2 at the end. So first you evaluate this whole integral as usual. And then after integrating it, we shall substitute the limits. So x constant, integration of e to the power x is e to the power x. Differentiation of x is 1. Integration of e to the power x is e to the power x. 1 into e to the power x is e to the power x. 1 to 2. X e to the power x minus integration of e to the power x is e to the power x. Limit 1 to 2. So first we shall substitute x is equal to 2. 2 into e to the power 2 minus e to the power 2 minus 1 into e to the power 1 minus e to the power 1. These two terms will be cancelled. 2e square minus e square, you know, is e square. So finally, this is the answer of question number 3.